startling. Joining me right now is Dr. Okachukwu Olozi. He's a member of the Texas Medical Association's Coronavirus Task Force and infectious disease doctor as well in El Paso, Texas. Doctor, thank you very much for being here. El Paso was actually named by Dr. Deborah Birx as one of the cities that she is watching very closely right now as it's seeing a significant increase in cases. We were looking yesterday, El Paso reported its highest single-day infection increase since the pandemic began. What are you seeing there? What is going on and how bad is it?
First of all, thank you for having me. I think, as you know, Texas passing 10,000 cases, El Paso having over 300 cases the other morning, we're really concerned. As we sort of came out of our lockdown period, the stay at home, and we're expanding, people started to engage. We didn't have a clear mask policy. We weren't really socially distancing or physically distancing. And so now we're seeing some of the repercussions of that. We still hope that with testing and getting people to change their physical dynamics, that we can get on top of that.
For sure, that is the hope. The state reported the highest number of deaths in a single day yesterday. What does that tell you about where you are in terms of the outbreak and in that ultimate goal of getting this under control?
I think it's very concerning, right? We all know that cases come before hospitalizations, which come before deaths. And so any action we take today, we still have a four-week lag time. I think that's really important for people to understand that there's no immediate fix to this. This is something that we're going to have to collectively change as individuals and as a community. And that's really the only way we're going to get around it.
The lag time is something that it appears a lot of people have a hard time with, that it's not a one-day change in behavior. It is long-term, and you're not going to see the benefits of it for quite some time. That seems to be a really – why do you think that seems to be such a hard a challenge for people to accept as we've seen this go on?
There are a number of reasons. I think, first of all, people aren't really familiar with how viruses work and how the spread of viruses work and sort of that natural history of an infection. And I actually feel as if sometimes, even though you guys in the press have done a great job, we in the medical community have been sort of torn around our messaging. And so what should have been clear from day one is that this is just early on, right? So to steal a metaphor from Dr. Michael Osterholm, we're in the third to fourth inning of a nine-inning game. We're going to have to hunker down, and not just that, our actions have a lag. There's a delay. Just like muscle memory, you don't go to the gym and all of a sudden get strong overnight. It takes 3 to 4 weeks to see those developments and those gains. And we're going to have to really put in the work to get ahead of this epidemic.
Avoiding the gym is also not going to help us get past this, that's for sure. But actually, in this one, avoiding the gym might actually help us get past this, because I want to get to your chart that you put together that I think is extremely helpful in informing the public about the level of risk that various behaviors and our various actions have. The Texas Medical Association put this chart together, and it lists out activities and lays out the level of risk for each. The lowest risk is opening mail, eating takeout, playing tennis. On the higher end of risk in this chart, it talks about going to a bar, going to a movie theater, going to a gym. And I read that and I realized that two of the three of those are still allowed in Texas, going to the movies and going to the gym. Does that make any sense to you?
It's more important to me to really focus in on that responsibility, right? So Texas, we really do believe in personal responsibility, and individuals are going to have to make the decisions that they're going to have to live with. But I think they also have to remember that their individual decisions affect our community. As a TMA member, what we really wanted to focus on was giving people a guide. Right? These are not hard and fast, and I truly believe that reasonable people can argue about where certain things in this ranking are, but it fills that vacuum where people were asking us, what can we do, what can't we do? If I were making a decision, probably wouldn't go to a packed bar. We also understand that by drinking alcohol, it changes your behavior. You remove your mask, you don't wash your hands, you're in close quarters. And so understanding that being outdoors is always going to be better than indoors. Few people is better than more people. And just sort of those sort of constructs, I think that really is what people need to determine how can they be safe as they continue to try to live their lives.
Absolutely. Dr. Alozi, thank you very much. I think this color-coded chart is actually quite helpful for everyone with some of the questions that everyone has, going to a public pool, all sorts of things. It's a good reference point to take a look at. I appreciate your time.
I appreciate you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.